Hello students, today we are going to start with class 12th political science chapter 4 alternative centers of power. So let's start. Today we will discuss the role of some important regional organizations. For example, the European Union. Then we talk about the next regional organization, that is the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. This is also known as ASEAN. Then we talk about the rise of the Chinese economy. Then we talk about our last topic, and that will be South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. So today we are going to start with our first topic, that is European Union. Why the need of European Union, or why we need European Union? As you all are aware that after Second World War, the economic structure of the Europe collapsed. In that time period, the America tried to provide moral and financial assistance to countries whose political unity was in danger. So, during that time period, in 1947, American Secretary of State George Marshall presented an economic recovery program for Europe, and that was known as the Marshall Plan. Why they started this Marshall Plan is because they want to improve the economic condition of the European Union. And this program or this initiative was known as the Marshall Plan. So this is the starting of the European Union. After establishing this Marshall Plan, they started with different organizations or cooperations. So in that, our first cooperation is the Organization for European Economic Cooperation. In order, why they started it? Because in order to provide assistance to countries of the Western Europe under this Marshall Plan, they want to know that how they are going to help them. So for that, they developed the Organization for European Economic Cooperation, and it was established in 1948. It was the forum where European states began to cooperate on trade and economic issues, so that with the help of free trade, they can establish their economy. Then in that Marshall Plan, there is one more council, that is the Council of Europe. It was established in 1949. Its main aim is to provide the help or to make the strong political cooperation between the European countries. So that Council of Europe was a step forward in the direction of establishing a European Union. So that also helped them to provide the political cooperation. Earlier it was European Economic Cooperation which helped them to provide the economic establishment or economic support. But now the Council of Europe, it start to establish a political cooperation between the European Union. Then they started with the European Economic Community. It means earlier they have already started with the two type of organization. That first one is Organization for European Economic Cooperation. Then they talk about the Council of Europe. Now they are talking about the European Economic Community. In this, which type of rules and regulations or policies they are going to follow. So European Economic Community, it came into being by a treaty of Rome in 1957. It means they signed a treaty in Rome in 1957. After that, they established the European Economic Community. Initially, it was signed by the representative of 6 European states. But later on, more nations joined it. Gradually, the number of member states went on increasing. And by 1986, 12 countries had become member of the European Economic Community. It was also known as the European Common Market. Why they established this common market? So that they can integrate the economies of the member state. This treaty provides for the ultimate abolition of all custom or the barriers. They want to remove the barriers between these states. So this results in free flow of goods, men and capital from one country to another. It means indirectly that economic community also helped to make economy strong of the European country. Then after that, the European Union came into existence. So as you all are aware that after the collapse of Soviet bloc, there is a new type of blocs where America wants to take all the power or the other countries want to take the more power. After that collapse of Soviet bloc, now the European Union, they established rapidly because now they think that the more countries will become member of their union. So it result in the establishment of the European Union in 1992. So what were the aims of European Union? As you must have understood that now they want to establish a trade, or they are focusing more on the economic condition and political condition of the European Union. So the main aim of the European Union are common foreign and security policy. It means they want to establish a common foreign policy and security policy between the European countries. Then they try to cooperate on justice. Means whatever the problems they are having, they should only trust on the justice. Then they talk about the home affairs, that all the countries should have their own affairs, or they can should concentrate more on their own politics. Then they want to create a single currency. Why they are focusing on the single currency? Because so that they can create the economic stability. Because if there is a single currency or a single currency accepted by everyone, they can establish or promote the growth and prosperity throughout the region. They can also promote or make the stable economic environment. So these are the main aims of the European Union. So we can say that European Union was established so that they can establish the economic, political stability of the European states. Now we will start with what are the roles or how it impact. Okay, so what are the influence role of European Union? So first one is its economic influence. First, they want to establish the single market. They think that if they eliminate all the traffics and restrictions on the free flow of goods, people, capital and technology, so as a result, the European Union has emerged as the world's largest single trading bloc. So that is why they want to establish a single market. Then they are saying that we should develop a single currency. And they accepted a currency, euro. They want that everywhere they should have a single currency. Earlier, and there were only 12 members who opted for this currency, and they say that it is very benefited for the businessman or for the bankers. So they started it because they want that economic environment can be promoted, it can provide better opportunities for the investment, or it could promote the growth and prosperity throughout the region. Then they talk about a single voice in global economic affair. They say that if we are united, so if there are any problems at the global level, or if there are any economic crises at the global level, we can face all that difficulties together. Then they talk about the gross domestic product. They are saying that if the free movement of goods and capital, European Union's GDP will definitely increase, and it was around $12 billion in the 2005. So this can also be achieved. Now, what are the political impact of the European Union? Political impact are, European Union has two members, that is Britain and France. They are the permanent member of the UN Security Council, as they play an effective role in influencing world politics. Now, European Union government have often acted in collaboration with the USA, but on several occasions there was no unanimity among member countries regarding some of the US policies. If we take example, so example is when the US attack on Iraq, Britain and Spain were on the side of US, but France and Germany opposed this action. So this is how the European Union put political impact. Then we talk about their military capabilities. What are their military capabilities? They are the European Union combined armed forces, because after combining they can be the largest in the world, but they are the second largest in the world after the US. Then two European member states have nuclear arsenals, like they are having military equipments. Then it is the second most important source of space and communication technology. This will also put a military influence. So these are the influence or influential role of the European Union. So broadly, if we can divide it, if there are three influence: economic influence, political impact and military capabilities. So now we are going to discuss about the limitations of European Union, because as we already discussed about the why European Union started, what are the main impacts, now we move towards the limitations. There are some limitations. For example, bigger European power like Britain, France and Germany, they were unwilling to give up their independent policies in the world politics. They don't want to agree, or they are not in the favor that they every time they have to follow the European Union policies. They said that if we are the independent countries, so we can have an independent policy towards the world. Then the next limitation is a common constitution was not accepted by all European countries. European Union was saying that we should accept the common constitution, but European countries are not in the favor of accepting the European constitution or the common constitution. Then the last one is national currency. It means that they are saying that currency of most of the countries were replaced by euro, because they are saying that we have to establish a single currency. But Denmark, Sweden and Britain have not agreed to give up their respective currencies, because they think that they should have their own currencies. So this is all about this European Union. So after finishing the class, you have to read the political science NCERT book from page number 51 to 55. And you have to solve the assignment in your notebook properly.